Fox is so cute and cuddly. I just want one to be my pet. Well, the next best thing is to breed two foxes together and make the resulting baby trust you. Now, while this is not as amazing as having an actual tamed wolf or a tamed cat, it's the next best thing. But it can be kind of tricky to do because the foxes always want to run away from you as fast as possible whenever they see you walking up. And the only way to stop that is to have a tame one. So like, it's like a chicken and the egg problem. How the heck do you do it? Well, I'm here to show you how to tame or to get a fox to trust you in complete survival mode. So let's jump in. So here we are inside of Minecraft, and I know that I said that I would be doing this in survival, and I'm in creative right now, but that's because I want to show you what you need to find in survival. You need to find foxes as close to each other as you possibly can. You need to find a taiga biome, because that's the places, or a snowy taiga biome. That's the places where foxes spawn, and run around it. You may accidentally startle a fox, causing it to run away, but as long as it's during the day, it will eventually go back to sleep. And you need, once you find a fox and that it is asleep, make sure that you are crouching all the time. I'm going to use these guys as a little bit of an example. If I'm crouching and walk up to the fox, I keep looking at the sun because the moment that the sun goes down, these guys are going to wake up. I can walk over to these guys right here, and they are none the wiser. They don't realize that I'm here. But the moment that I stand up, these guys are going to run away, and they hate me. So you need to make sure that you're crouching all the time around them. Whenever you come across a block that you need to get down, you can always jump instead of uncrouching to get down it. And then when you want come across one that you need to come up, you can jump to get above it as well. Now, what you need to do next is to get two foxes in the same like pen situation within blocks so that they are not going to move around. It's okay if one of them is a baby fox like this right here. We'll just have to wait for that fox to grow up before we do the next step. If you're having trouble with this step, there is another tip that I can give you, but we want to make sure that there's at least a too high area here so they can't just run out of this. And placing blocks is fine, destroying blocks is fine, all that is fine. Then you can unshift, and you should see that they... Hello, little fox? There we go. A little bit of lag, I think. But now they can't get out of the pen that I've created. Make sure that this isn't transparent, and that no... chickens come by, because they can jump over a wall if there's a chicken nearby and they can see it. But as long as they can't see it, everything should be fine. Remember, the moment I crouch, it's like they love me. The moment I uncrouch, they freak out. Crouch, they're fine. Uncrouch, freaking out. If you happen to come across a singular fox like I'm doing right now, where there's this single fox and no secondary fox around to start the breeding process, you can always do the same thing that I did before, block up next to them, or you can place a boat on right next to them. You can't ever place one right on top. And then come to the other side of them where you know they're going to escape towards that boat, and then unshift, and they will try to run away past the boat and then get trapped inside of the boat. And now you can get in the boat and boat them around wherever you want. And you can now use this as a way to keep him there and find another fox somewhere and then trap him in the same way, get them close together, and then get them into the same pen together. After you have successfully trapped two foxes, what you are going to want to do is feed them sweet berries, and that will start the breeding process. So let's grab some sweet berries. We go, give them one, give them to the, whoops, I didn't mean to throw that on the ground, give them to the other, then they love each other, and bam, you get a baby fox as a result. This baby fox will now be the tamed version of the fox, and will trust the player that made the baby making happen. Now, that does not mean that they are as tame as a wolf or a dog, so they still will not follow you. The only difference is they won't run away from you when you are nearby. Now, so as you can see, those two guys are freaking out when I unshift, but the baby is not. Now, they will continuously follow an adult nearby. That's just baby behavior. So if I was to break this box open, the baby would follow the adult, making it look like it's not tamed. So keep that in mind if you're worried that you didn't actually tame the fox, that it's still freaking out. It's probably just following an adult nearby. What I would suggest doing is naming the fox. Now, it doesn't need to be named because it will not despawn, but naming it will make sure that you can tell it apart from the tamed foxes versus the untamed foxes. So come to me, little fox. Come on. There we go. Little fox. Little fox been named. So this is the behavior. This is the behavior I was talking about before. Oh, man. That the little fox will follow an adult fox and look like he's running away from you, because he's just following the other foxes as they run. Don't forget that foxes can be led around. Oh man, that creeper's gonna get me. So if you need to, you can grab your foxes and use the lead on them to get them from one spot to another. So if you have a tamed fox that isn't near your base and you want to bring him back, you can use the lead on him to get him to follow. There you go. I hope you enjoyed it and enjoyed this video. If you want to catch future videos, tips, tricks, tutorials, and spotlights, make sure you hit subscribe and get those notifications as fast as possible. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. It really helps the channel out, and I'll see you next time on OMG Craft. Bye.